So my name is Ashlee Robison, and I am a junior going into my senior year here at Fort Lewis College, and I'm majoring in chemistry. There are several reasons why honeybees have been declining worldwide. The one we're focused on here at Fort Lewis College is the Varroa Mite, which is a parasite that was introduced in the late 1980s from Asia and is the largest parasite in North America of the European honeybee. So the Varroa Mite is a very small parasite that actually attaches itself to the bee's body and sucks the hemolymph, which is the bee's blood. And it actually decreases the bee's immune system, so it weakens them and allows them to be attacked by other diseases more easily. Chemicals are being used currently to treat the Varroa Mite in North America. Thymol is actually used right now as an anti-mite treatment for honeybees. Thymol is the smell of thyme. The problem is the way that we're delivering the thymol. So right now, it's a solid and it evaporates into the air, and the problem is getting it to every part of the hive. So where the young bees are developing, the older bees who are in charge of taking care of them, the nurse bees, have capped those cells, and that's exactly where the mite reproduces. And so we cannot get in there because it's capped over and protected. So we are synthesizing a thymol molecule attached to a glucose molecule. So in the springtime, when honeybee colonies are gearing up for the summer honey production season and they're building up the numbers in their hives, beekeepers feed them a solution of sugar water. So essentially, what we're doing is attaching a thymol molecule to a sugar molecule, and then once bees ingest that, they have the ability to break that chemical bond, so the thymol then becomes activated in their systems, and so when a Varroa mite attaches itself and goes to suck the hemolymph, the bee's blood, then it will kill the Varroa mite. No matter where the bee goes in the hive, the thymol is active in the bee's body, so there are parts of the hive that have previously been inaccessible that are now accessible to treat for the Varroa mite. Well, I want to know why bees are dying off, I want to know how to fix it, and I wanted to do the research myself. And so that's how I got really interested in this work and why I love it, because I understand what's happening at a molecular level and I can help fix the problem. I am looking forward to meeting other people who are working on really, really interesting research and talking to them and getting to meet a ton of different people in the chemistry world. I've never been to a large group event like this, so it'd be really fun, I think.